Hey guys, DLC 2, Guns, Love, and Tentacles for Borderlands 3 is now live. This DLC is about the marriage of Wainwright and Hammerlock, and it will take you to a new planet called Xylorgos. On Xylorgos, you're going to encounter new areas, new missions, and new characters. And just like in DLC 1 and also the base game, you're going to be able to complete crew challenges for rewards. One of the crew challenges is going to be linked to a brand new character that you're going to encounter in this DLC, and you can find him in the lodge. You'll find him behind the bar, and his name is Mancubus Bloodtooth, and I personally find this character hilarious. The crew challenge is called Mancubus Eldritch Statues, and this involves cultists that have left statues around Xylorgos in honor of ancient and terrible deities. He wants you to destroy them so that he can restore order to the Eldritch Pantheon. If you go into your menus and then toggle to the right, you'll be able to see this crew challenge and see the icon that's associated with it. I'm going to show you guys where all these statues are located and then show you the legendaries that they drop and also the reward that you'll collect once you destroy all of them. There is a way to track to see which statues you have destroyed. If you go underground behind the bar in the lodge, there's going to be a statue back up against this wall. When you destroy the statues, it collects a crystal that will put it into the statue, and if you're missing any, you'll see a green holographic crystal in its place. You can interact with them to see what location they're in. It won't tell you the map, but it will tell you the region of the map that it's in. And as you can see here, I've got 4 of the 5 shards, so you will have to locate 5 statues around Xylorgos and destroy. I'll show you guys all 5 locations of all 5 statues, but first I want to show you guys the reward that you get once you destroy all of them. This statue right here is located in the Cankerwood map, and you can see that I am hovering above the location right here. So these statues are not easy to deal with. If you're on Mayhem Mode 4, they're very difficult to break, and they also fire a laser beam at you that can get you down pretty quickly. This location here on Cankerwood was easy because there was no enemies in this area. It wasn't near a camp, and I was able to take a little bit of cover and avoid that laser. The laser is actually coming out of that crystal or shard that you're going to be collecting once you destroy the statue. Once you destroy all 5 statues, you'll get a pop-up on the left showing that you got mail from Mancubus, and I'll show you guys what that is. But first, I want to show you guys what these statues drop as far as legendary. I farmed all 5 statues multiple times, and they only ever dropped the new class mods for the 4 characters. It was really tough to get one of these, and I was even on Mayhem Mode 4 that increases your loot quality, and I had to farm these things over 50 times before I even got one, so it's going to be very rare if you do get one of these new class mods. Here are the new class mods. For Amara, it's Stone, Flack is Trainer, for Zane, Conductor, and Moe's Sapper. I never saw these statues drop any of the new legendary weapons, but they did very frequently drop one of the new skins from this DLC. It's called Tentacular Spectacular. You're probably gonna get this every 4th or 5th time that you farm the statues. Here's the skin right here. It's got hints of green and it turns the eyes green. Sit back to the statues and the reward that you're gonna get after you destroy all 5. Again, you're gonna get an email from Mancubus, so go into your social and check your email. He will send you the reward. It's called the Lodge Poster, and you need to accept it here. It will go into your backpack. You select it again to unlock it. This is going to be a room decoration that you can access and put up on the wall, and here's a close-up shot of what this poster looks like. It says the lodge, and then it's got a bunch of tally marks and says stay indefinitely. So now I'm going to show you guys the other 4 statue locations. First, I'm going to show you the map name, then the location on the map, and then I'll physically go there and show you. I'm not going to voice over the rest of this video. I think it's pretty self-explanatory. But here is the Dustbound Archives and where it's located on the map, but hopefully this will help you guys out, and we'll see you next video.